In this episode, we talk about how showing honest and sincere appreciation will help you become more likable to your boss and colleagues. What's up, everyone? This is Jake Voorhees, and you're watching episode 19 of the 1% Engineer Show. We're on to principle 2 for How to Win Friends and Influence People, the best book in the history of career success. The core of this lesson is about positive encouragement to one's accomplishments instead of focusing on the imperfections that they showed. I can relate to this because a long time ago as a camp counselor, I began to understand that positive encouragement is a much better yield to behavior improvement in the campers than punishment and the threat of negative reinforcement. People don't respond to that. This is why kids break rules, because if you say, we're gonna go get ice cream if you are good, they're probably gonna be good, so they go get ice cream. But if you say, you're gonna be grounded if you do this, they're gonna do it anyway because they believe they're gonna get away with it. So negative encouragement doesn't work ever. And the same holds true in a work environment, in a classroom environment, in a college environment. If you positively encourage people, if you show appreciation and praise to their good behaviors, that person is going to want to keep yielding this productive result for the group, for you, if you're the team leader, for people at work, if this is a professional environment. It's the only way to create a positive cyclical situation for everyone being awesome is positive reinforcement. I'll give you guys a few examples from this book right here. John Dewey, a famous philosopher, said the deepest urge in us as humans is the desire to be important. If you're criticizing people and not showing appreciation for what they're doing, not showing praise, then they don't feel important, they feel condemned. And just like in episode 1, we know that that's no good. So showing appreciation is what should be happening. And here's one story about a man named Charles Schwab, who you may recognize as the financial company today. But Charles Schwab was one of the first people in America to make more than $1 million. He was the president of the US Steel Company, as appointed by Andrew Carnegie, one of the most successful business people of all time. And why did Charles Schwab make so much money? Not because he knew the steel industry, but because he had the ability to manage people well. Schwab said himself, "I consider my ability to arouse enthusiasm among my people the greatest asset I possess." He understood it's praise that people seek, to feel important rather than be condemned for their mistakes. Another quote in this book comes from Ralph Waldo Emerson, who said to be hearty in your approbation and lavish in your praise, and people will cherish your words. They will remember them forever. And speak about them when you're not in the room. So think about this in your engineering world, how you can instill praise, how you can instill sincere appreciation in your circles, in your workplace, in your classroom, in your internships, and you will see the results. Avoid mentioning what someone should have done and mention what they did well. That's really what people want to hear. You will find your relationships improving. Go ahead, go do it. And comment on this video about what you agreed with or what you disagreed with, and please subscribe to this channel so I can reach more 1% engineers like you. Thanks for watching the 1% Engineer Show, guys, and stay hungry on your quest to become a 1% engineer. Cheers!